This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. These are the words we just sang in our responsorial psalm. We rejoice and we are glad because Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. That's the Easter proclamation of the church. That's the source of hope for all of humanity. Like Mary of Magdala and Peter and John in today's gospel, we go to the tomb of Jesus on this Easter Sunday morning, and we discover that the tomb is empty. And the words of our second reading penetrate our hearts as we are told, you know what had happened. They put this man to death. The one that God raised on the third day, and all who believe in him will receive the forgiveness of sins. That's why we rejoice. That's why we are glad. Because Jesus Christ forever has destroyed the power of sin, suffering, and even death itself. In just a few moments, the church invites all of you to renew your baptismal promises. And so today we reflect on the meaning of our baptism. Baptism is a death. It's a death to sin, to an old way of living, to destructive patterns that keep us from living with integrity and in holiness of life, so that we can walk in the light of Christ. And all who die to sin will receive the forgiveness of the Lord. Next Sunday is Divine Mercy Sunday. It's a powerful reminder that when we confess our sins, the only other thing we have to say than the expression of our sorrow and our desire to sin no more is, Jesus, I trust in you. Trust in Jesus to heal you, to forgive you, to raise you to newness of life, so that you may know the peace and joy of his resurrection. We rejoice and are glad because Jesus Christ is alive and with us. And he is with us most intimately in this celebration of the Eucharist. For every time we celebrate the Eucharist, Jesus himself renews his holy death on Calvary and its glorious glory and resurrection. Dear friends, the Eucharist is the source of our strength. It's that precious gift that sustains us here on earth as we make our journey to heaven. Without the Eucharist, we are lost. Without the Eucharist, we are helpless. So promise anew today to receive Jesus at Mass each and every Sunday at the Holy Eucharist, to participate consistently in the life of the Church, and gently and lovingly invite others to do the same. Dear brothers and sisters, be filled with joyful hope. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad, because Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. Alleluia, alleluia.